Good morning. God bless you. God bless everybody. This is Pastor Perry with the Wings of God, and we're having sunrise service, so I'm going to step a little to the side, and you can see the sun is rising. But today, we're talking about the Easter. A lot of people, before we begin, dear Lord, Father God, I ask you to bless all the people that hear the message today. I ask you, Father God, to give them blessings wherever they are. And through this coronavirus, I ask them to be safe, Lord. I ask you to be by them sides and not let them worry. I ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Today is Easter. Some of you don't know what really Easter is. On Friday, Jesus was put on the cross. And on the third day, he rose again. And that would be today. Today, Jesus rose. But the purpose of Easter is not so much that what happened is the gift that we were given. Salvation. Everyone has sinned. Everyone has made mistakes in their life. But the Bible says that your sins must be paid with blood. There's no ands, ifs, buts about it. Someone has to die. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so whoever believes in him would have everlasting life, John 3:16. What I'm saying here is Jesus said, I will come down to the earth right now. I will come be as a man, and I will give myself. I will live as man, and I will suffer. In other words, what he would do is he would take the price on the cross so we wouldn't have to pay the price ourselves. Because unfortunately, folks, we're not good enough. There's nothing that we can do that can rectify what we've done. And sin is sin. The first question we ask is, what kind of sin will put you in wrong with God? Every sin. From the time that you were little and you stole something that you knew shouldn't have stolen, from a pen to a piece of paper to a candy, to when you were an adult and you made fun of somebody, to the point that when you were outside and you were driving your car and you yelled at somebody. We were all sinning against God. But how do you pay it back? You can't. So Jesus gave back his life, gave his whole life so we could have ours. And when you watch and think about Jesus Christ on the cross and all the suffering that he did, he started when he was put on the cross, and then before he was beat, he was beat because of us. He was beaten because of me. Of all the things that I've done in my life, I did it to Jesus Christ. I was watching The Passion of Christ last night, and I was reminded that it was me that caused Jesus to be beat. It was me that caused Jesus to go on the cross, because without him, no one can go through the Father. As the Word says, you have to go through Jesus to go to the Father. You see, Jesus is the way and the light. For all those that are wondering what's going on in this coronavirus times, this is the time to sit back and evaluate yourselves. Have you done right in the eyes of God? You have to contemplate what you've done in your life. Have you accepted Jesus Christ, or have you been a sinner? But the wonderful thing is, Jesus has set us free through this day that we received. We received salvation to him, through him. You see, this is what it's all about. Jesus saved us. I'm trying to just fix this, and I guess it's not going to work. So Jesus saved us. But you see, the thing is, what is salvation? Salvation is simple, but very hard. You have to give yourself to God. You have to say, I'm really sorry for what I've done to you, Jesus. I'm really sorry that I have offended you, God. I didn't follow the things that I'm supposed to do. You're supposed to ask yourself, what can you do? Well, you can't fix yourself. You'll always make mistakes. Yeah, you'll always make mistakes and you'll always do things wrong. But that's the thing, that Jesus forgives you, even though he died on the cross one time. You're saved every day. You can, long as you ask God for forgiveness and you accept Jesus into your heart. And accepting Jesus in the heart means that you're going to change the way you walk, the way you talk, the way you live. You're going to accept and follow him. And let me tell you, when you do, things will go right. Things that you thought would be wrong aren't going to be there anymore. You're going to go and you're going to walk around and you're going to know God is in your life. Because you see, you won't worry about dying. You won't worry about the coronavirus. You won't worry about anything because you know God is in your heart and in your life and you've accepted Him. You see, we need to remember that Jesus rose from the dead. He's the only one. If you look at all the other deities that they say they have, no one has risen and is alive as Jesus. Jesus' tomb is empty. If you look where the other prophets and other people died, guess what? They're still there. Their bones or whatever, they're still dead. But Jesus is at the right hand of our Father right now, looking down on us. But there will become a time when He comes back, and He's not going to come back to save. He's going to come back to judge. And you need to ask yourself, are you ready? Are you ready in your heart? Are you ready in your life to accept Jesus? Are you ready? Because when He does come, saints of God, it's going to be too late. You can't change your mind. You can't say, oh, I know Jesus is here now, because the Bible says very clearly, there will be wailing of tongue, gnashing of teeth and wailing of voices, and every knee shall bow. That means they know that God is God and He's here, but it's too late to repent because He's already here. I'm not saying the world's going to end today. I'm not going to say the world's going to end tomorrow. But you don't know when your time here is over. You could be standing up and have a heart attack 2 minutes from now. You could be driving tomorrow and have a car accident and die. And if you did not accept Christ, it's too late. I love the story when Jesus was on the cross. And this is the pinnacle of what I'm saying about today. There was two other individuals, two thieves. One thief hollered at Jesus and said, if you're the Son of God, why don't you just take yourself off the cross? Prove to us. Show that who you really are. But the other thief said to him, he got mad at the other thief and said to him, hey, this man has done nothing wrong. We are receiving our just punishment. We are receiving what we deserve. He is innocent. Then he looks at Jesus and says, will you remember me when you go into paradise? And Jesus turns to him and says, you will be with me. You see, you can accept Christ at any time in your life. Just before the moment of your death, you can. But the problem is, you don't know when that's going to be. And what can Jesus do for you? He does everything for you. He can save you. Let me tell you some of the things. I've seen Him bring people from the brink of death and fix their bodies. Are you worried about your finances and all these other things? Jesus can take care of that fear. Now, the finance problems may stay. You may have the worst job in the world. You may have the worst car in the world. You may owe so much money to the banks. But you see, you won't mind because you're in the hands of God. The purpose of Jesus is to set you free. You see, but you have to accept Him. Here on Easter, He rose from the tomb. There's nobody in there. They came and they looked, and the tomb was empty because Jesus now was with God. And He proved them right. What the prophecy said, He proved them right. He had come to fulfill the prophecies, and He did. There's one big prophecy not left that hasn't been filled yet, and that is Revelations. But we'll get back to that later. But right now, folks, I'm concerned about you. Have you accepted Jesus Christ? Have you accepted Him in your heart? Have you really, really accepted Him? He can save you. Wouldn't it be great for you to wake up in the morning and not have any worries about your job, not have any worries about where your next meal is going to come from, just not worry, just to have a gladness in the heart? I can remember one time I was driving down the road and I was thinking, and I said out loud, you know, if I die right now, it is okay because I am with God. If another car just smashed me and is over, I wouldn't worry because I'm in the hands of God. These times that we're in right now, coronavirus and all these things happening around the world, war, famine, pestilence, You don't have to worry if you accepted Jesus in your heart. You don't have to worry about what's going around because you are in the hands of God. You won't have fear. But as the sun rises behind me on a cloudy day, you'll know that Jesus is there. The sun will rise tomorrow, and the sun will rise the next day. But the question is, will you rise today, or will you rise tomorrow? So I ask you right now, as I get ready to close, have you accepted Jesus Christ in your heart today? Have you accepted Him? Have you let Him really come into you? And as I get ready to close, I'm a motorcycle chaplain, and I spoke to this motorcyclist yesterday, and he gave a wonderful testimony. He says, you see, God does not care how much money you have. God does not care what clothes you wear or where you live. And here was a man that didn't have much. He wasn't living the right life, and he had accepted Jesus. And he had changed his life, but his son was blind. He was just, 100% blind. And he was at church, and I was told that they were singing a gospel. Instead of having a sermon, they were singing gospel music. And all of a sudden, the drummer just quit. And everybody looked around because you need the drummer. And he quit. And when he quit, he said, I got to do something. They said, where are you going? We're playing music, gospel now. He goes, no, I have to leave. God told me to do something. He goes back and gets this boy, and he brings him up. And you know what happened? His sight was restored. He's 38 years old right now, that boy. And if you ask him what happened to your sight, he'll tell you, Jesus gave my vision back to me. Jesus gave me my eyes. He is all powerful. If you got a problem in your life, there's nothing too hard for Jesus to take care of. There is nothing too difficult. And let me tell you there, folks, there is nothing that is too difficult for you. God will not let you get into a position that you cannot handle. So what does that mean? You can handle everything with God. There is nothing. You look at the Bible and people say, what about death? Well, you know what? There were people that were put on the cross. They were executed also. They did it with Jesus, but they were prepared for it. They were ready for it. That He knew they could handle it because they had a bigger purpose in their life. But we have problems just handling a little coronavirus here and there, or you know, you get the mumps, or you get a cold. And you ever seen people with the, you know, they get a cold and they act like they're about to die? You know who I'm talking about. Those people too. You don't have to worry. God is with you. You can say, I can get sick, but I'm not worried. I can be broke and living on Section 8 housing, and it's okay. I don't even have to have a car. I can be walking to work because I can't even afford the bus, but it's okay because I got Jesus in my life. And as I close, I want you to ask yourselves today, have you accepted Jesus? Have you accepted this gift that He gave this week? He gave His own life to pay for the sins that we all did, and we will continue to do every day. Are you willing to accept that gift? Are you willing to say, Jesus, I need You. I'm tired of living the life that I've lived. I'm tired of just being tired. Let me tell you, there is a way out. His name is Jesus Christ. He's alive, and it proves it. That tomb right now is empty. If you go to where He is, there's nothing in there because He is at the right hand of our Father. He is looking down at us, and He loves us so much He suffered for us. He did things, had things happen to Him that He did not deserve, and as I said earlier, I deserved. But yet, He took it for me. So I ask you right now, if you want to accept Jesus, I just ask you, if you're listening on the internet right now, or you're just at home or just wondering, I just want you to lift your eyes up and say this prayer with me. Father God, I ask You to come into my life. I ask You right now to take over my life because I'm not in charge, that I don't know what I'm doing, It's obvious I'm not a God, Lord, that you are, because of all the problems I have, my personal problems. I worry day for day. I say this, Lord, Father God, to the people that even lost relatives and husbands and wives, that you are not alone. You are not alone in this world because Jesus is with you. But I ask you right now, if you have any of those problems in your life, just give it to God and God will save you. And if you accept Jesus in your heart, you're saved. But I'm also speaking to those that already know Jesus Christ, that feel that God isn't there. He is there. He has never left you. This is the time for you to get back on your knees and say, Lord, Father, God, I want to be with you right. I want to be right with you. Give me the strength to be a good Christian, to be a good person in your eyes. And remember, if you're a Christian, you're listening to this, do everything for His glory, not yours. When you give food, give it for His glory. Don't need to put your name on it. Let them know it is because of Jesus. Because like when I said about that story when the kid got his sight back, what does he say to this day? It was Jesus who gave my sight back. Not the man that brought him in, not the church, not the people. It was Jesus Himself. And Jesus can do that for you. In the name of Jesus, amen. If you have any questions, you feel free to send a message on this site that we're going to be. Leave a message, and if you want prayer, we'll do that for you. With that, may God bless you, your family, and wherever you are, and happy Easter.